with the shepherd of risen, who laid down his life for his sheep and willingly died for his flock. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, the Lord be with you. Welcome to our Mass this Easter morning on the Monday of the third week of Eastertide. Today we offer the Mass for our parish priest, Father Brian. He begins a week's rest this week. We can't go away on holiday at this time, but it is his Easter break. So we pray for him that he will come back refreshed, relaxed, and ready to continue to lead us, inspiring him. First, brothers and sisters, let us call to mind our sins, and so prepare ourselves to celebrate these sacred mysteries. Lord Jesus, you have revealed yourself as the way to the Father. Lord, have mercy. You have poured out on your people the Spirit of truth. Christ, have mercy. You are the Good Shepherd, leading us to eternal life. Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Amen. Let us pray. Grant, we pray, Almighty God, that putting off our old self with all its ways, we may live as Christ did, for through the healing paschal remedies, you have conformed us to his nature, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever. Amen. Reading from the Acts of the Apostles. Stephen was filled with grace and power, and began to work miracles and great signs among the people. But then certain people came forward to debate with Stephen, some from Cyrene and Alexandria, who were members of the synagogue called the Synagogue of Freedmen, and others from Cilicia and Asia. They found they could not get the better of him because of his wisdom, and because it was the Spirit that prompted what he said. So they procured some men to say, "We heard him using blasphemous language against Moses and against God." Having in this way turned the people against him, as well as the elders and scribes, they took Stephen by surprise and arrested him and brought him before the Sanhedrin. There they put up false witnesses to say, "This man is always making speeches against this holy place and the law. We have heard him say that Jesus the Nazarene is going to destroy this place and alter the traditions that Moses had developed." The members of the Sanhedrin all looked intently at Stephen, and his face appeared to them like the face of an angel. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. They are happy whose life is blameless. Though princes sit plotting against me, I ponder on your statutes. Your will is my delight, your statutes are my counsels. I declare my ways and you answer, teach me your statutes. Make me grasp the way of your precepts and I will muse on your wonders. Keep me from the way of error and teach me your law. I have chosen the way of truth with your decrees before me. They are happy whose life is blameless.
Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Man does not live on bread alone, but on every word that comes from the mouth of God. Alleluia,
reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. After Jesus had fed the 5,000, his disciples saw him walking on the water. Next day, the crowd that had stayed on the other side saw that only one boat had been there, and that Jesus had not got into the boat with his disciples, but that the disciples had set off by themselves. Other boats, however, had put in from Tiberias near the place where the bread had been eaten. When the people saw that neither Jesus nor his disciples were there, they got into those boats and crossed to Capernaum to look for Jesus. When they found him on the other side, they said to him, "Rabbi, when did you come here?" Jesus answered, "I tell you most solemnly, you are not looking for me because you have seen the signs, but because you had all the bread you wanted to eat. Do not work for food that cannot last, but work for food that endures to eternal life, the kind of food the Son of Man is offering you, for on him the Father, God himself, has set his seal." Then they said to him, "What must we do if we are to do the works that God wants?" Jesus gave them this answer: "This is working for God. You must believe in the one he sent." The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Let us lift up our hearts to the throne of God, where Jesus' Son is living and praying for us. Lord, help your people throughout the world to celebrate this Eastertide with faith, love, and joy. Have mercy on all who refuse to accept Jesus or have forgotten him. Help those who are searching for an unknown God. Through your Holy Spirit, let them discover the face of Jesus Christ, true God and true man. Teach us the lesson of the gospel miracles, so that we may truly honor Jesus in our lives. That this whole day may be perfect, holy, peaceful, and sinless, we ask you. Lord God, teach us at all times to fear and love your holy name, for you never withdraw your guiding hand from those you establish in your love. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you. Fruit of the earth and work of human hands, it will become for us the bread of life. Blessed be God forever. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you. Fruit of the vine and work of human hands, it will become our spiritual drink. Blessed be God forever. With humble spirit and contrite heart, may we be accepting of you, O Lord, and may our sacrifice in your sight this day be pleasing to you, Lord God. Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, our Almighty Father. May the Lord accept the sacrifice at my hands, for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church. May our prayers rise up to you, O Lord, together with the sacrificial offerings, that purified by your graciousness, we may be conformed to the mysteries of your mighty love. Through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is right and just. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, at all times to obtain you, O Lord. But in this time above all, the Lord you yet more gloriously, when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. He never ceases to offer himself for us, but defends us and ever pleads our cause before. last one slain who lives forever. Therefore, overcome with constant joy, every land, every people exults in your praise, and even the heavenly powers with the angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim, Holy, Holy, Holy Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory, Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord, Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy therefore these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time when we prayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it, gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. Similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. Mystery of faith. You proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that by taking on the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity. Together with Francis, our Pope, and Mark, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, his fathers, with the Blessed Apostles, with St. Alphage, who sees all today, with St. Michael and all the saints of creation throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and we pray to glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Saviour's command, borne by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Saviour Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. The peace of the Lord be with you all. This evening, the body of God, our Lord Jesus Christ, be kind of love for us in this evening. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Peace I leave with you, my peace I give to you. Not as the world gives, do I give it to you, says the Lord. Alleluia. Almighty ever living God, who restores to eternal life in the resurrection of Christ, increasing as we pray the fruits of his Paschal sacrament, and pouring into our hearts the strength of his saving food.